See, the next part that we are doing is percentage composition. Empirical formula. And molecular formula. Okay, the first part of this is percentage composition. Okay, definition of percentage composition is very simple. It is the percentage of each of the elements present in a compound. Okay, let us take very simple example, H2O. Okay, RMM, that is its molecular mass. This will be 2 multiplied by 1 plus this is 16. So this is going to be 18. Okay, now as per definition, percentage composition. So we are here, how many elements are there? Hydrogen and oxygen. So percentage of hydrogen, this will be the mass of hydrogen divided by its molecular mass multiplied by 100. This is going to be here the mass of hydrogen. There are 2 hydrogen atoms, so its mass is going to be 2 divided by molecular mass of water is 18 multiplied by 100. Okay, this, if you work this out, it is going to be 11.11%. Okay, the other element that is present over here is oxygen. So percentage of oxygen, this is going to be the mass of oxygen that is present divided by its molecular mass multiplied by 100. This is equal to the mass of oxygen that is present over here is 16. So 16 upon 18 multiplied by 100. This, if you work this out, it is 88.88. You have to round it up. Okay, so it's going to become 88.89%. Okay, when you add the percentages of each of the elements that is present, obviously it should come out to be how much? 100%. Okay, so we are going to work out a few examples of this, and then we are going to move on to the next topic, that is empirical formula. Let's take some examples. Percentage composition of each of the elements. First one is sulfuric acid. Next one is nitric acid, hydrochloric acid. What is common amongst all three of these acids?
All have hydrogen.
All have hydrogen, that's okay, but all these acids, we also call them mineral acids. Okay, these are the three standard mineral acids because they are found in the mineral of the earth's crust. Okay, so these are three mineral acids. Then other examples also we can take. Okay, sodium hydroxide. Fifth one is iron 3 sulfate. The formula of sulfuric acid is H2SO4. Okay, H atomic mass is 1, S is 32, O is 64. So this will be 2 into 1 plus 32 plus this will be 16 multiplied by 4. All these will add up to 98. Okay, so the first of these percentage compositions, percentage of hydrogen. This is going to be the mass of hydrogen divided by its RMM. Relative molecular mass of sulfuric acid multiplied by 100. This is equal to, okay, mass of hydrogen, there are 2 hydrogen whose mass will be 2 upon 98 multiplied by 100. Second is percentage of sulfur. That will be the mass of sulfur upon RMM multiplied by 100. This is going to become 32 upon 98 into 100. 32.5%. Similarly, we can work out the percentage of oxygen as well. Percentage of O, that will be mass of oxygen divided by RMM multiplied by 100. That will be 64 upon 98 into 100. Okay?
65.31.
This is 65.31. percentage. Again, if you add up all the three percentages, it's going to work out to 100%. This percentage will be 2.2. Yes, now there are similar questions based on this. Find which of these is a better fertilizer. Okay, the first one of these I'm giving you is ammonium nitrate. Second one of this is urea. And third one of this is potassium nitrate. All right, now the question asked is find which of these is a better fertilizer. I know which are the fertilizer elements basically. NPK. Just remember this short form. N stands for nitrogen, P stands for phosphorus, and K stands for potassium. Okay, now here we have to see which of the elements is common in all three of these. The formula of ammonium nitrate, if you try to work this out, it is going to be NH4NO3. Okay, afterwards in organic chemistry you will learn the formula of urea, which is going to be NH2CO NH2. The formula of potassium nitrate is going to be KNO3. Okay,
potassium nitrate will be
No, we'll have to work out the percentage of all the elements that are common in each one of them. You can see nitrogen is there. So in all three cases, you are going to work out the percentage of nitrogen. And whichever gives you the maximum percentage of nitrogen, that is a better fertilizer. Okay. Now here there are two nitrogen atoms. So here, obviously first what we are going to do, each one of these, we are going to find out the RMN and we are going to calculate the percentage of nitrogen. Whichever gives the maximum percentage of nitrogen, that is a better fertilizer. So we'll start working this out. Okay, here there are two atoms of nitrogen. The first case I'm doing, that is ammonium nitrate, that is going to be N2H4O3. I've combined both the nitrogens together. So this is 28 plus hydrogen is 4 plus 16 threes are 48. Okay, this is going to add up to 80. So we'll work out the percentage of nitrogen in the first case, which is going to be 28 upon 80 multiplied by 100. This figure works out to be 35%. The second substance or compound that is given to us is, okay, urea, that is NH2CONH2. Just write them in the combined form. N is 2, H is 4, C is 1 and O is 1. Okay, we can just work this out. Okay, this will be 28 plus 4 plus 12 plus 16. This is going to add up to 60. So here also for urea, percentage of nitrogen, there will be 28. The mass of nitrogen divided by RMM of urea, that is 60, multiplied by 100. Okay, this percentage works out to be 46.67%. This is the percentage of nitrogen that is present in urea. Now the last of these substances that is given to us, that's potassium nitrate, that's KNO3. K is 39. Nitrogen is 14 and 16 into 3, this is going to work out to be 48. This will add up. This is going to become 101. So here also percentage of nitrogen, that will be here 14 upon 101 multiplied by 100. Okay. This is going to give us 13.86%. Okay. So you can see here in case of ammonium nitrate, the percentage is 35%. For urea, it is 46% approximately, 46.6. And here it is nearly 13%. Okay, so in terms of nitrogen, here urea is the best fertilizer. Okay. No, when we are considering as a fertilizer, we just have to take up the common element. Okay. If you are looking up for potassium, in that case, then potassium should be there in all three of these compounds. Okay. So that's what we have to see. There are several questions in your past papers also. So those also I will send you. Next part is empirical formula. Okay, tell me the formula of glucose. C6H12O6. Okay, the actual number of atoms that are present, the number of carbon atoms is 6, the number of hydrogen atoms is 12, the number of oxygen atom is 6. So the actual number of atoms that are present over here are 6 carbon atoms, 12 hydrogen atoms and 6 oxygen atoms. This number that is being represented, this formula that is being represented is the molecular formula. Now is there any common number amongst all of three of these elements? 6 is the common number. So if I divide all these by 6, what formula I'm going to get? I'm going to get C H2O. Correct? All three of these numbers are divided by 6, so I'm going to get CH2O. This is the smallest ratio in which the number of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen atoms are present. This formula that is representing the smallest number, this is known as the empirical formula. So the definition of empirical formula is very simple. It is the smallest ratio of each of the atoms present in the molecule of a compound. Okay. Molecular formula is going to be the actual number of each of the atoms present in the molecule of a compound or a substance. Okay. So this is empirical formula and molecular formula. We'll just consider a few more examples. Yes. Then you can't divide it. Then molecular formula and empirical formula will become same. Correct? Then in that case, molecular formula and empirical formula will be same. Suppose if I'm considering another example, say KMnO4. Now this is one and this is one. So the empirical formula is also this and molecular formula is also same. Okay? In the previous example that you were telling, C6H12O6. Suppose if I am having another compound whose formula is C6H13O6. In this case, the molecular formula and empirical formula will be this only. Because you cannot divide this by 6. Clear? Any other question? Let's take example of benzene. Okay, the molecular formula of benzene is C6H6. What will be its empirical formula? Correct? Its empirical formula will be CH. Take another example, say butane. These all will come later in organic chemistry, what all these substances are. The molecular formula of butane is C4H10. What is its empirical formula?
C2H5.
Okay, C2H5. This is quite very this is very simple to understand. The next part is, from the percentage composition that is given to us, we will be able to find out the empirical formula. And if RMM is given, we will also be able to find its molecular formula. Okay, so this is our next part. Percentage of alright, now there is a compound of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. The percentage of carbon that is present is 40%, percentage of hydrogen is 6.67% and remaining part is, okay, the relative atomic masses. Carbon is 12, hydrogen is 1 and oxygen is 16. So we are going to find out the moles of each of these substances. That is the number of moles. Okay. Now how we are going to do that? The number of moles. So this will be percentage of carbon divided by its atomic mass of carbon. Okay. This is going to become percentage is 40 divided by 12. If I am going to divide this, this is going to become 3.33%. Then number of moles. We are considering that is of hydrogen. So percentage of hydrogen divided by its atomic mass, which is 6.67 divided by 1, will give me the same number, 6.67. Okay. Then the number of moles of oxygen. This will be percentage of oxygen divided by the atomic mass of oxygen. Percentage of oxygen, how we are going to get 100 minus these both. Okay, so this is going to give me 53.33%. Divided by the molecule, the atomic mass of oxygen, which is 16. If you divide this, this comes out to be 3.33. Okay, now here you see the number of moles of each one of these substances that we have got. We are going to divide by the smallest of the numbers, each one of these values will be divided. 3.33, 6.67, 3.33, the smallest number is 3.33. So each one of these will be divided by 3.33. This is going to become 1. This is going to become 2. This is going to again become 1. Okay? So the empirical formula is going to become CH2. Because this is in the ratio, okay, carbon is 1, hydrogen is 2, and oxygen is again 1. So its empirical formula is CH2O. Alright, now let's take the next part. Suppose here, the RMM of the compound is given. Suppose its relative molecular mass is 180. Then we have already found out its empirical formula, which is CH2O. Find out its molecular formula as well. Okay, now here the first thing that you calculate over here is its empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass, this will be carbon is 12 plus hydrogen will be 2 plus oxygen is 16. This is going to be 30. Okay, now 30 is how many times is going to give me 180? 6 times. So this empirical formula straight away it will be multiplied by 6. This is straight away going to give us the molecular formula. Okay. So CH2O that is multiplied by 6 that is going to give us C6H12O6. This is the molecular formula. Okay. On the basis of this we are going to have several numerical examples.